For the Christian, no matter what we are doing as work, we are admonished by the Apostle Paul to do it as unto the Lord. That's what he told the Colossians. That choice, that exercise of our human freedom, deciding to treat our daily work differently, places us in the position to receive the grace we need from the Lord. And we learn how to both view our work and do our work differently. This enables our work to change the world both within us and around us. And this renewed way of viewing work includes all human work, not just what is sometimes viewed as the spiritual stuff. The Word incarnate, Jesus Christ, did not just do what is often called the spiritual stuff. All human work sanctifies us, makes us holy, and changes the world around us. Beloved Father, through the life, death, and resurrection of your only begotten Son, Jesus the Christ, we have become your adopted sons and daughters. Through baptism, we are now members of his body, the church. Our Savior Jesus taught us that whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and sister and mother. We thank you. That promise includes each one of us. As members of the family of Jesus, we turn to you in prayer. In Jesus, we are joined in a communion of love which is stronger than death, along with the saints, the holy ones. They are the great cloud of witnesses the Bible speaks of. They've gone before us, marked with the sign of redemption, and they live their lives by faith. They inspire us by their holy lives. They also pray for us from their place in your communion of love. And a special place of honor in that communion is Saint Joseph. He said yes to your call to be the chaste husband of Mary, the mother of the Lord, the foster father of Jesus, and the guardian of the Redeemer. A man of few words, Joseph spoke with action and calls us to the way of active faith. The patron of all workers also shows us the dignity of all human work when joined to Jesus. Joseph always said yes to your invitations of grace. He always put Mary and Jesus ahead of himself. And he invites us to do the same in our own daily lives. The carpenter who taught the child Jesus to work with wood in the workshop of Nazareth now shows us that all human work participates in the loving plan of redemption. At 33 years old, Jesus, the carpenter's son, freely embraced the wood of the cross and reconciled us to you and to one another for the sake of the world. Joseph loved Jesus, and Jesus loved Joseph, and that love continues. Saint Joseph, you who love Jesus with a genuine fatherly love, we now ask you to pray for us as we follow the way of Jesus in our everyday lives. You understand the challenges of raising a family, earning a living, facing the difficulties of life, and always remaining faithful to God. We now turn to you and we ask for your intercession. By your prayers, obtain for us the special graces we need to be faithful to our own specific vocation and to live our lives in service to Jesus as you did. Saint Joseph, today, I specifically ask you, and now here, add your own specific intention. Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Saint Joseph, the worker, pray for us. And may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come upon you. Thank you.
trần thế hát khen công đức người, chôn thiên đình tôn vinh danh thánh ngài, xin dìu dắt chúng con qua vòng tâm tối về quê trời bên nhân thân.
Con Chúa Trời ban thành sanh nữ chính Maria, xin dìu dắt chở che giáo hội Việt Nam luôn trung thành theo thánh ý mà thôi.
Thánh dù sanh rồi là đã nêu gương gia đình cho nhân thế, giúp chúng con thoát mê lầm, đoàn con dạy thiên nguyện ứng được cha đoái thương.
Cha đoái thương